this plant, which I don't want you guys to touch, okay? This is one of the more poisonous plants at the top of the mountain, although it is found all over the show.
I gotta get me a sample of that.
Okay.
So this is what we call a blister bush, basically, okay? So the first person, the way it works, the first person who comes into contact with this specific plant is not affected. They only activate the poison.
Oh, okay? I like that.
And the second person who comes into contact with the specific plant actually starts breaking out the rash where the plant came into contact with the skin. And once this rash gets direct contact with the sunlight, it basically gets irritating. And you scratch it and it basically spreads all over the body.
Wow.
So they say that the only way to stop it from spreading would be to cover the rash up from direct sunlight.
Okay.
But obviously if you're in weather like this today, you stand a much better chance of making the rash go away because there's no sun. But also again, back in the days when there was no medicine, if any people walked up against this, the traditional healers would normally say that the aloe vera plant over here behind you guys, okay? So this is what we know as aloe vera.
Yeah.
Okay. So some indigenous people or traditional healers, they say that the aloe vera tree has certain healing qualities or certain soothing qualities when it comes to the rash of the blister bush. However, I would still recommend you to go to an actual doctor to get it checked out, okay? Yeah. But like this aloe vera tree and like many of the plants at the top, this is used for different skin products, hair products, you know. I once saw a video where they actually cut the leaf of the aloe vera tree open, okay, and the ladies actually use it on the hair. I'm not sure what it does. It probably makes it silky or something. But they definitely do that, okay. And if you are interested in getting any aloe products, if you're going down to Boulders Beach, where you find the penguins, there's actually an aloe vera store over there which sells all the different aloe products over there. Okay,
well,
guys?
Penguins.
Yeah, by the penguins.
I don't know. South Africa. On the southern tip, family. Yes. Yes, Sam, we need to take some of these plants and go to the lab. Huh? This is incredible view, family. We're just going up in elevation. I don't think you can go any higher now, right? That's it.
It gets higher than this.
Where?
Not too much higher though, okay? You won't really feel the height, but at the moment we are about 1,067 meters above sea level, okay? And the highest point of the mountain, which is called McClare's Beacon, it's about 30 minutes away from here. That is 1,085 meters above sea level. So it's only about a 20 meter difference. And McClare's Beacon is actually a man-made trigonometrical beacon. So it's not really part, it is part of Table Mountain, but it's man-made, okay? And the reason I'm stopping here, okay?
Whoa.
I want you guys to take a listen to that. So at the moment, we are standing at the top of a 150 megaliter water tank. Okay? So the reason for the water tank, there is no direct water pipelines from the lower station to the top station. Okay? So all the water which gets used in the buildings at the top, it's brought up via cable car. Okay, each cable car has a built-in water tank of about 3,000 liters. And during the evenings, we have a night shift team who works night, and they basically transport the water to the top and pumps it into this reservoir over here, and from there it gets dispersed to the buildings. Same like our toilets, okay? The reason why you were getting a type of a smell when you walked past the toilets, we only basically use about a foam cup's worth of water when you flush the toilets. And then from there, that same water gets recycled and a chemical gets added to that water, okay? And there's no sewage line to the bottom for the toilets, so we hook a separate tank onto the red cable car in the evenings, pump all that sewage waste into the separate tank. From there we take it to the lower station and that sewage gets pumped straight to the Cadbury chocolate factory. Okay. And chocolates are made.
No, you're funny, yo. You're funny, dude.
Okay, you, come on, let him hit it again. I'm going to record that. Yeah. Say, hold on, let
me. Is there any questions so far, guys? Yeah, let's get that. Another one?
Yeah.
Hold on. Right, all right. Hold on. Don't hit it too hard.
Just don't fall through.
So there's actually a ladder that goes down over there, and the reason why it's so empty at the moment, it's basically due to previous water restrictions which has been placed on Cape Town about a year and a half ago. Okay, it's much better now, however, but we still save water and only try to bring water up when it's actually necessary for us to bring the water up. Okay, guys?
Yes.
I'm not sure to be
different.
Oh, a ball. A ball, yes, but not the specific one.
No, no,
though.
Not that one. But
that one you would get lower down the mountain. But it's called the ball. They actually started that during the water restrictions, and they would go to different people's yards and they would find out where they can find boreholes and bore water. But that water, it's not for drinking purposes. It's mainly for watering gardens, maybe doing your washing and so forth. Okay? Lovely. So you're gonna stop around the top of the rock over here for us, guys?